to my dog with oil pastels. And I am using a set of oil pastels that has 25 different colors. One thing I like about oil pastels, if you've never used them before, they are kind of like crayons, only they are much more rich and soft. So they blend nicely. So they're really fun to use if you haven't tried those. So I need to pick out some colors to use with my dog. Again, I've got my reference here. Now, of course, you don't have to print it out. You can just look at it online to give you ideas of how to add color, or you can use your own colors. You don't have to use normal colors. You can make fantastic colors or crazy colors, bright neon colors. Now you'll notice around where his hat is sitting on his head, there's a shadow there. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that in too while I'm doing it. I just do a little bit of black across the top and I'll blend it. I have to be careful, the black can kind of get crazy. I like to use more than one color when I'm coloring. color in. I'll start out with one color and then I'll add a second one on top to blend it. As if the light was coming from this direction, it would start lighter and get darker. So that's how I'm going to color it. And then my hand's not too dirty, I'm going to blend it. One thing I like about oil pastel, it's almost like paint. When you're finished, it looks almost like you've painted it. Now I know I've got a lot of mess over here on the side, but that's okay because I'm going to paint the background. I'm going to use my oil pastels in the background and I'll cover all that up. So I need to think about his shirt. I think I might do the same color that was in my reference picture. I think I might do kind of a green. That is very bright, so I might add a different green on top of it to tone it down. Although you can keep it bright, there's certainly nothing wrong with that. You can see it picks up the black, so it adds a lot of, just adds some interest. It doesn't really bother me. I'll take this little bit more subtle green, little, and add to it. And then I can blend. I think blending oil pastels is fun. I like how it leaves a lot of different textures and colors. All right, so now I have to figure out what am I going to do with this tie. In the picture he had a dark blue tie, so I think I'll do that. Kind of a turquoise. I like that. So I'm going to add a little dark blue on one side. Can't hardly see it. Just adds a little depth to it. Okay, now do I want to do anything to his shirt? I think I'm going to leave his shirt white and then I'm going to paint, do the background. So now the background can be any color that you want. It's going to be solid though. So I want to think about what color I'm going to use for my background. I want it to be different than what I've got so far. Like I don't think I want a blue, although it could be a different color of blue, not this same color of blue. I could do a real dark blue background, or I could do a darker green background, or I could do a completely different color background, like a yellow. I think I'll do a yellow. Now, when I'm getting close to the edge like this, I'm going to need some protective paper. Okay, so I've gotten some protective paper, and it's just a big piece I can slide under here to protect my table because it gets pretty messy, and oil pastel is pretty messy. So let's see, I think I said I was going to do a yellow. So I'm going to choose two different yellows because I really like blending with the oil pastels. I have to be careful when I get near the black. I mean, I don't mind if it gets a little bit because it adds some interest. I just want to control it a little bit, and I'm going to color loosely because I'm going to go back over with my other yellow to add some interest and variety. I can always, if I have black on my oil pastel, I can always wipe it off on my background protective paper. Now I've got some kind of marks over here, and if I had not chosen a yellow, those would cover up. But you know, it doesn't bother me. And with art, you want to not worry so much. Sometimes the mistakes turn into really nice, they call them happy accidents. And I'm going to take my second color. I like that. I can go back and I can blend it with my finger. I don't have to color it all in. I can, but I don't have to. There, now it's kind of rough. I kind of like it rough. Or I can go back in and I can add a lot of smoothing with my finger to blend in some of the colors. Makes a nice textured background though. Okay, so there's my dog. He is very good looking, and I hope you enjoy making your dog too. Thank you for joining me today in Mrs. Hoover's art class. I hope you enjoyed making your dog portrait, and I would love to see your artwork. So if you would like, you could email it to me at mrshooversartclass@gmail.com. And until I see you again, remember, every day is a great day to make art. Bye.